So today what we're going to see in this video is how to do a backup and restore of configuration parameters in the IND360 through the web server here. So this is an IND360 that I have not set up so far, but I'm going to change a couple of settings how I like them. Notice we've got a red flashing light up here. So I'm going to do something to take care of that, along with changing my capacity and increment values to what I need them to be. So I'm going to go to scale, capacity and increment, and I'm dealing with pounds here for this installation. And let's say it's 1,000 pound setup, and I don't need much readability, so half pound is more than enough for me. So I'm gonna make sure I hit set there, acknowledge that it was successful. And then to take care of this error, this alarm, I know it says control network failure because it's not talking to a PLC, so I can let it know it should not expect a PLC by coming down to my communication settings and disabling supervision. So I'm happy with that now. I've got a green light. My capacity is set how I would like it to be. So what I'm going to do is once I've got everything changed how I need it to be, under maintenance, I'm going to go to update and backup. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this configuration block here on the right side of the screen, and I am going to just simply select backup. And that will generate in my downloads folder of my computer a config file, which I can load in the future if I were to ever master reset my device back to factory defaults, or if there was some problem with the unit and we needed to take it back to a known good state. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually show you how to load that now after master resetting my device back to factory defaults. We'll restore this configuration and see what happens. All right, so the master reset is complete. We can see I've got this red flashing light once again that I click on. It'll once again tell me I have a control network failure. And if I go back to my capacity and increment, you can see we are reading a 60 kg capacity. It's very far off from that 1,000 pound capacity at half a pound increment size that I liked. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to load my backup back in. So I'm going to select choose under the configuration and update and backup, and it's this config number 6. So what this is doing is it's telling me the file name, the hardware ID, what the firmware version was for that backup file, and then it's doing a check here to make sure that this backup is compatible with the hardware I'm connected to. Now what's very important to know is this drop-down option here, override adjustment parameters. So maybe you took a backup maybe a few years ago, you've had multiple calibrations since then, and you don't want to overwrite those adjustment parameters. So there you would select no. In this case, I'm just going to select yes, and then I'm going to select restore. So we see that restores, we see that our red flashing light has gone away, so that fix that we implemented earlier has taken effect. And just to double check, we can go to our scale and our capacity, and we see we're back at 1,000 pounds at half a pound increment size. So a successful restoration of that backup configuration. It is as simple as that. So until next time, thank you.